was 2007. The future for Marist football was uncertain.
It was somewhat of a evolution, I think is the best way to put it, as several of the teams in the MAC conference dissolved their football programs. And we went from having 10 team, very similar commitments in football league, shrinking down to 9 to 8 to 7.
Only two teams remained in the Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference, and in 2007, the MAC took its football program off life support, forcing the Red Foxes to join the Pioneer League. In 2009, coming off a disappointing 4-7 campaign, it was time to take on the big dogs of the PFL. The Foxes would win on the road at Sacred Heart in a non-conference matchup, but then came the home opener. After a strong start, Marist fell to Drake University in its first conference game of the season, 34-6.
6-yard touchdown run for Drake.
Do you have any expectations playing San Diego next week?
Well, we're going to regroup here and we're going to go back out and fix the things. Everything that happened today are fixable things, you know, penalties, turnovers, those type of things, and those things that we can correct and come back and play a better football game next week. And, you know, we'll regroup just like, you know, coming off of last week's win, we put that one behind us after Sunday. After tomorrow, we'll put this loss behind us and start concentrating on San Diego, knowing that it's a long season. It's an 8-game conference schedule, so we know that there's a lot of football to be played.
The next two games would play out in similar fashion.
Take that speed and do a left hand stretch too.
Oh!
Got
the bank.
As with all epic tales, one man leads the charge. Rory Foley, the first ever junior to be named captain in the history of the program, is the man for the job.
Well, obviously it's an honor to be like the captain and to have a leadership role on the team. But, I mean, at this level, people kind of know what they need to do, and everyone's just kind of there to do their part and pull their weight.
Loved by players and coaches alike, Foley, a native of West Roxbury, Massachusetts, is as dedicated to the sport as anyone can be, and makes noticeable strides to be the best man on and off the field.
You go out to practice, and you know whether you need him to do something in an interview or if you just want to just get out there and just see how everyone's doing, Rory's always got a smile on his face. He's always ready to play football. He loves football, and that shows with what he does on the field too. He's just been an incredible force for this team. I mean, first of all, you don't normally see guys make the impact that he did as a freshman. Well, he made that impact as a freshman. As a sophomore, well, he set the program record for interceptions in a season.
The hardest guy to coach for you as a coach is your best football player, especially when he's not your hardest worker. I don't have those concerns with Rory. He's one of our hardest workers in the weight room. He's a very hard worker on the practice field. He does well academically.
Playing behind Rory, he kind of sets the bar for me as far as play-wise, as far as being a man, as far as my morals, my character, on the field and off the field. And, you know, every day I try and reach the level that he's at to make myself better.
Out to the Pioneer Football League because they were very similar schools, had very similar interest and commitments in football,
competition in the league is a lot better than what we had anticipated. The teams are more athletic than what we thought. They're very much a lot bigger than what we thought also. Speed-wise is what we actually had thought we were going to get going into the leagues.
What we thought the league was, and I think what we're finding out it is two very, very different animals, if you want to put it that way. The competition level's been much higher than what we expected it to be every week. Every team we face is pretty good.
Top to bottom right now, these teams have proven to be better than what we had anticipated going into this thing.
Parity and his assistants didn't have an awful lot to sell other than a great campus, great academic institution. But when you're going up against schools in the Ivy League and the Patriot League, they have that as well. So now I think we've evened the playing field a little bit, you know, with the league and with the field, you know, and the lights for practice and so on. That I think it leveled the playing field in terms of recruiting. We were able to recruit a higher level talent, and I think we're just starting to see that now. I think we have two solid recruiting years, but with football, because of the number of kids, you need several recruiting years to change a program.
One thing I've really enjoyed about seeing this program join the Pioneer League is the fact that it's a level playing field again. I think that Marist Football enjoyed a lot of success in the 1990s as a member of the MAC Football League, playing against similar-minded schools with the same goals and aspects of football. And it's good to see the program return to doing that again here.
Two running that same type of combination. Drake showed us quite a bit. One in, one out. And then usually some type of vertical or curl on the trip side with a nine or a curl at the top side.
Film sessions have become a daily routine for the players now that they are facing a slew of different teams. These meetings require the utmost focus from everyone involved.
It's really important to us defensively, the product that we put out on the field. I talk to them a lot about, don't forget, this might be someone's first time that they're seeing you play. How do you want them to perceive you, whether it's here at Tenney Stadium, or it's in San Diego, California, or Moorhead, Kentucky?
After the meeting, the players take to the field to participate in scrimmages and drills. Everyone is required to give 100% at all times, from the starters, to the scout teams, to the injured. Sometimes the players can't keep up. Sometimes the coaches lose patience.
Get your asses out of the damn drill! Get your asses turned back! Stop hanging out!
But regardless of what obstacles they hit, the Marist football team presses on, knowing they have a statement to make every week in their inaugural season in the PFL. After being picked to finish near the bottom of the Pioneer League during the preseason, the Foxes were sitting at 5-3, their last home game looming on the horizon. The last time for the seniors to make their mark in Poughkeepsie.
As a coaching staff and as a senior leadership and throughout our team, we look for a winning season, number one, getting into winning the league and getting into the postseason and play against the Northeast Conference. That is our number two goal.
Thank you. caught up around.